So the last video I did, I shared with you the clay construct of the, you know, how the clay is actually looking. And today's video is primarily about looking at the water quality that is coming from the pond that is being changed. Now, as you can see, the water is still running. A point to note that whenever harvesting is taking place, it doesn't necessarily mean that this harvesting is done within a day. Sometimes the water is periodically released because you have roughly between 15,000 to 20,000 tilapia within one pond, right? And to harvest so much fish, I call it kilograms worth of fish, several kilograms worth of fish, you actually need opportunity to actually, what you call it now, collect, process and store these fish, right? So it takes some time to actually catch all these fish from out of the large 3-acre and 4-acre ponds. So for days the water might be running, and they might do it periodically, like probably release half of the water and then now get some fish. So sometimes the pond is like tilting, so you'll have like it's going down a slope, so they will gradually release the water, and what you find is that the pond will force the fish to actually go to one end of the slope, one end of the pond. As a result of that, you have a period of time before the water itself is actually cleared from the space. Now what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be catching some of the water into this bottle, right? And I'm going to be taking it home, and I'm going to be doing a comparison between the water quality in my pond, in my little pond. Wow, I feel like I'm going to drop, guys. In my little pond, right? So this is where the water comes from out of the pond. So I'm catching some of the water, right? Right, so I'm catching some of the water. There's a lot of snails here, guys, right? So I'm catching some of the water. You can smell the fishy scent from the water, right? This is coming from the large ponds, guys. And this water is like in the pond for roughly like 7 months, 8 months, right? This is how it looks, right? Now I'm gonna be comparing the water from my pond to this water. I tried to get a pH testing kit. I couldn't get any. I tried to get water testing kit. I couldn't get any. So I'm just gonna have to satisfy with doing visually a comparison of the water between my pond and the pond that is being released water from Danny Bunting Fish Farm. Stay tuned. So if you look good, you'll see some of the tilapia. Wow, that looks like a that one looks like a Rocky Mountain White. It's right there in the corner. If you look good, you'll see it, because it looks like the water, you're not really seeing it all that, but I know that you can see the white one, the white one on the corner, right over there, right? There are some, those look like fingerlings, right? They are in that hole, and this is where the water would flow from over that space, from over that space, into where I just shared with you a while ago, right? So you're looking at the water is not all that green, not all that rancid, and this is like one of the ponds that is being released. This is not the pond that is being released. Another pond, because obviously the pond that's being released should probably be nearly drained right now, because as you can see, this pond is full to the brim, right? And right now Clarendon is experiencing a drought, so I don't think this is any wasted, right? So let's go check my pond water, changing my pond water and comparing the you know, everything with it. Okay, so this is a sample of the water collected that actually is being, what I call it now, released from Danny Bunting, one of Danny Bunting's fish farm, right? It does have some amount of algae in it. You can't run away from that in fish farming, whether commercial, private, domestic, whatever. You can't run away from that, right? However, I'm going to be saying something now, and I wanted to say it clearly so that you understand it and don't take me out of context. Okay, I'm not going to be taking out the water from out of my pond right now to share with you. I'm going to be looking at it, right? I'm going to be looking at it from this angle, from upward downward. You'll realize that the water is really green, right? If this was a earthen pond with clay, the water would not be green like this, right? If this was an earthen pond, clay on the bottom, and you're just looking at the top, you would find some amount of algae in it, but the algae wouldn't be more than roughly 1.5 to 2 inches on the surface. Right below that 1.5, 2 inches, you'd have clear, clean water. That's because algae thrive on sunlight, and below that depth, what you find is that sunlight is it stops to shine that bright when it goes below a certain depth. So therefore, the impact of the sunlight on the earthen pond water is practically less than a containers like these, right? So containers like these, they do get sunlight from the top, from the sides, from all four sides, and from the top. So even if I should like cover this section with something, right, not necessarily the sun rays per se, but the light itself will continue to penetrate the container, and so the algae will still strive within the water. The water will become green, right? The thickness of the algae is dependent on the amount of light that penetrates the container, right? As far as Danny Bunting ponds are concerned, the water is relatively not as green as how I would have it within my pond system, right? Partially, this is because roughly the entire space, water space, is not overladen with algae. And the algae that is there, the fish is allowed at times to actually consume the algae. Thus, as a result of that, you find that there's little or no problem with the magnitude of algae that exists within the space. So you won't find Mr. Bunting complaining that algae is taking over his spawn, and as a result of that, the fish is unable to survive, right? Bearing in mind, the aeration of the pond is mostly done at night, right? The aeration of the pond during the day is done by the wind moving on the surface of the water that actually helps to aerate the pond. It makes no sense to put plants and weeds within the pond itself, because the tilapia, the adults, will actually consume the roots, right? So therefore, to say that aeration have led to the clearness of the water beneath 1 or 2 inches within the large pond space, that would be less disingenuous, because you know that's just not the case, right? The same too with my breeding tub, the tub in which I use as what I call it now, broodstock. And my goldfish pond is partially covered with zinc, right? This zinc actually helped to prevent the thickness of the algae from actually override my entire pond space. I'm not gonna feed you guys, so don't bother come up, right? They themselves also consume algae, but not as much as the tilapia, right? And as far as aeration is concerned and algae is concerned, my fingerlings, they also consume algae, right? They also experience algae within the water space, right? Now, whether or not I cover the pond, yes or no, light will actually penetrate the container, right? So therefore, I will always have if I have a measuring kit to test to see the degree of algae within my space, within my water space, I will find myself having more algae than Mr. Mountain, right? Because my space is small, one, and two, my space is above ground, so therefore water, the water is actually penetrated by light because my containers is also clear. Now, for the containers in which I have over on this side of my yard, right, these containers haven't been, water haven't been changed for a while. Why is it might not be 7 months, right? Why is it might not be 7 months? Might be just probably about 2 months or 3 months, right? Right? As you can see, the algae is at the top, right? Same too in the earthen ponds, right? Algae is at the top, but as soon as you clear off the algae, you realize you can actually see the base of the pond, right? You can see the base of the pond. If I should just tip away the algae a little bit like this, that's algae that is at the top, I can actually see. And the partial reason is, one, the pond is dark in color, so therefore it doesn't allow lights to go through it. And two, it's underneath a shade tree. For the fish farmer, you don't have a shade tree, right? However, let's look at, let's say, in this pond. This pond is not too much underneath the shade tree, but at the same time, it doesn't have any algae, right? And, well, it has a little bit at the top, as you can see, right there. I'm kind of clearing it away, right? Right, these are my main gardeners, my breeding stock, right? I shift it a little bit, right? And you can actually see in the water, it's very clear. The container is solid blue, so the water, the light, you cannot penetrate the water that easy. The same too with this. I can shift away the algae, and I can see the water beneath it very clearly. And this is what happened on the commercial farm, 1 acre, 2 acre, 3 acre fish farm, right? Algae is in the water, but it doesn't penetrate all the way. It doesn't penetrate the 3 or 4 feet that probably some persons would think. Now, if you have an aquarium, right, and the aquarium is exposed to light, right, is exposed to light. Remember, an aquarium have 4 sides and the top make 5. So light is coming. I'm going into the aquarium from all angles. So you cover the aquarium top. Light will go into the left, the right, the back, and the front. So you can't really run away from that. The essence of this video is to share with you that earthen ponds have less likelihood or less probability of having green water. Even within the wild, where you have rivers and lakes and streams, right? The algae situation is similar. 1 to 2, 1.5 to 2 inches. And after that, the water is very clear. So therefore, the problem of algae within natural water space, it's like not really a problem to the fish, because if they find that they are having problems with the algae, they can just go beneath, and they have the means of, you know, reaching spaces that are oxygenated, right? The water is relatively clear like this at the top. And as you go down further into the pond, that's for the earthen pond, over by Danny Bunting, you'll find that the water becomes even more clearer. This is Riley here for another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica, guys. I hope that this video was of value, and that you took something away from this that you can actually apply within your fish keeping hobby, or you can share with a friend. Thank you very much for stopping by, guys. See you next time. Bye-bye. Peace out.